Welcome to a new Azure vlog. In this one, I would like to talk about the Microsoft Graph Security API and especially how we can use it to have external systems integrate with the alerts that we generate with Azure Sentinel. But first, let's get started with one basic question that I get asked quite often. What is the difference between the Microsoft Graph Security API and Azure Sentinel, as they both do something with alerts? Azure Sentinel is a SIEM solution, a security information and event management solution. We can use it to store our raw logs over there, do some analysis over those logs, and based on that analysis, we can fire alerts. The Microsoft Graph Security API is something completely different. It's a programmable interface. There's no user interface. We can only interact with it through a couple of SDKs or directly via a REST API. The Microsoft Graph Security API does not store our raw logs. It only stores alerts. If we have a look, for example, in Azure Security Center or Azure Sentinel, those products are able to generate alerts. And those alerts live in the first place in the product itself. So if you generate an alert in Azure Sentinel, you will have a case. If you generate an alert in Azure Security Center, you will have your alert over there. What those systems also do, they publish their alerts into the Microsoft Graph Security API. So aside from having the alert living in the product itself, it will also be published into the Graph Security API. So where do we use those tools for? Well, Azure Sentinel is a SIEM solution. We use it for our basic SOC processes. So we detect anomalies over there and we do some investigation based on the logs that are in Azure Sentinel. The Microsoft Graph Security API is our programmable interface to have external applications interact with the alerts that we generate in Azure Sentinel or being generated by any other Microsoft product that's being supported by the Graph Security API. In this Azure vlog, I will show you how you can have your external applications interact with the alerts that are being generated by Azure Sentinel. But first, I have to do this. I got comments a couple of weeks ago when I had a vlog there was no coffee in there. We need to make a good cup of coffee. So let me now introduce to you how we can use the Microsoft Graph Security API to connect our Azure Sentinel with an external system. If you have a look over here, I have my Sentinel overview open. Here we have an Azure Sentinel workspace. If we have a look at it, there are some cases in there. There are multiple logins from the same IP address. And yeah, from each case that is in Azure Sentinel, an alert has been generated in the Microsoft Graph Security API. So let us now have a look at the Graph Explorer. The Graph Explorer is a tool that's provided by Microsoft. I will put a link in the description of this video. And that will help you to see what data is in the Graph Security API. So we had a couple of cases in Azure Sentinel. For each case, an alert has been generated, so we should be able to visualize that through the Graph Explorer. So let's do that. Here I have the Graph Explorer. First, make notice of the fact that I'm currently logged in with my demo user. My demo user has permissions on the Graph Security API, so it is able to see alerts, secure score, and all security related data that is in there. So if I click on Show More Samples, and I enable the security samples, I have a lot of new samples that are in here in my menu. If I click on the alert sample, I will be shown all the alerts that are currently in my Graph Security API. There is also a sample for alerts with a high severity or alerts that are coming from Azure Security Center. And if we have a look at the top of this page, you will see the URI over here. And as I change these samples, the URI changes. So if I, for example, go to Show Alerts from Azure Security Center and I change ASC over here for Azure Sentinel, I will get all alerts that have been generated by Azure Sentinel. And here I have one, multiple login attempts from the same IP. I can use the Graph Security API to have external systems interact with alerts that are generated by the Microsoft Security products. And let me show you a logic app which demonstrates this. In this logic app, I will collect alerts, and from each alert, I will create a ticket in a ticketing system that's called Freshdesk. Freshdesk is an easy to use ticketing system, and it has a built-in connector for logic apps. So quite handy if you want to integrate with a lot of things. Let's walk through this logic app. It is a logic app that's triggered every 5 minutes. It's a scheduled logic app. The first activity that is being run is get the alerts. As you'll see over here, I filter on alerts. I filter on the provider Azure Sentinel, and the status of the alert must be new alert. So only alerts from Azure Sentinel that are new are collected via this activity. Then for each alert, I will create a ticket. And in the description of my ticket, I will put the alert title and also the alert description. Also assign an email address to it, a priority, a status, and as a subject, I use the alert ID. After I have created the ticket, I will update the alert. In order to update the ticket, I need to enter a couple of details that are given to me with the alert. So I need to enter the alert ID over here, the provider name, and the vendor name of the provider. And then I can change the status. What I'm doing over here, I change the status to in progress. And this will help me to make sure that alerts are not imported multiple times. Let me now go to the ticketing system. Don't get distracted by this limited access notification. I have a demo tenant on Freshdesk and that's actually expired. But what we see over here is a ticket of an alert, I must say. And it has a title, it has the ID of the alert that's in the Graph Security API. And if we have a look at the description, we see the title over here, and we see also the description. Quite awesome. So what you saw in this demonstration is, in Azure Sentinel are cases being generated based on alert rules. If a case is created in Azure Sentinel will also publish that case as an alert to the Microsoft Graph Security API. And what I did, I created a logic app that will run every 5 minutes and that will pull the Graph Security API for new alerts from Azure Sentinel. If there is a new alert, it will create a ticket in Freshdesk, and after that it will change the status of the alert to in progress. This is a way how you can use logic apps, the Graph Security API, and all the Microsoft Security products to have external systems interact with the alerts that are being generated by the security products. Quite handy, quite awesome. And with that, I would like to end this Azure vlog. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. You can contact me by Twitter or just post a message below this video. No problem for me. I will try to respond on them all. And of course, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.